All right, time to bring it on. We got some good ones today, Pat. Here's a viewer. She writes, I recently found out my husband has been cheating on me. He's basically been living with the other woman off and on while I was pregnant and through my delivery. He says he wants to make it, he wants us to make it, and then I should forgive him. He wants me to allow him to stay with the woman until he's okay to come home since he has unfinished business with her. I don't know if I can finish this question. All right. This is killing me slowly. What should I do?
I don't think that takes a lot of thought. The Lord said, you know, that in terms of divorce is permissible in terms of, in case of adultery. And there's no question this is adultery in the most blatant form. I mean, he is running over you like a lawnmower, and he's trying to make you a doormat and kick you around, and he's oblivious to your feelings, and this is insane. You shouldn't have, I mean, either he's living in a fantasy world, or he thinks that you're a sucker and he can take advantage of you. Get a lawyer. Get a divorce. I hate to counsel this because God hates divorce, but in this case, you don't want to stay around with this man because he said it'll kill you. It is killing you slowly. Get rid of him. Mm. All right? I mean, and you have all the grounds in the world, okay?
Amen. Nancy writes in, after Adam and Eve were cast out of the Garden of Eden, they had children. Their children married, but who did they marry? It doesn't make sense if everyone came from Adam and Eve, and that has always confused me.
Well, the laws about incest came in later on. I mean, you know, that's part of the commandments that were given to the people of Israel by Moses. So that was a long time after Adam and Eve. You know, one of the reasons, I mean, incest isn't too good a thing at all, but I think genetically the problem is that you pass on defective genetic material, and so your children are liable to be born with serious mental defects. Adam and Eve were absolutely perfect, and their children could, brothers and sisters, could have married together. They had to. There's no other way of having procreation. You know, in Egypt, the royal families only married each other. Of course, you'll get all kinds of genetic problems. You'll get hemophiliacs. You'll get other things like that, you know, blood diseases. But in Egypt, they thought that they were the pure line, and they had to keep it that way. So where'd they come from? Well, that's how it started. And then little by little by little, I mean, you get first cousins, second cousins, fourth cousins, and so on down the line. Then the next thing you know, they're not kin to each other at all. So there's no other explanation. I'm sorry.
Yeah, you're right. Well, Brenda writes, Pat, we have some teenagers in our church who do not bathe. How do we approach this subject with Scripture without hurting their feelings? Help.
Look, if a kid stinks, I mean, you know, hurt his feelings? Come on. It's gross. But, I mean, who do you talk to? You talk to their parents and say, listen, you've got a teenager who is really smelly, and this is outrageous. You've got to, you know, there used to be the saying, cleanliness is next to godliness.
And how can they stand themselves, you know?
The oil factories, dear, are the most easily adaptable of all of our senses. Mm. They adapt very quickly to unpleasant odors.
Wow.
I used to come in a small town where there are a lot of people in the hills, and they came out of the hills on Saturday, and I went to the cowboy movies in the Lyric Theater, and you talk about smelly. I mean, it was horrible. But you get used to it. You know, mm-hmm. I'm watching Tom Mix, and so that's all I care about, and the fact that the people all around me don't smell well, that's just too bad. You do adapt, so I don't know what else to say, but you certainly ought to. You don't talk to their parents, really. That's who they ought to consult with.
Yeah, don't be afraid to confront them.
It isn't your job to tell a teenager to take a bath. It really isn't. Tell his parents. All right, what else?
Rachel writes, my husband is a Christian. He says that since God hates divorce and he planned for spouses to stay married, what the Bible says about how a husband should love and treat his wife doesn't pertain to second marriages. He uses this as an excuse to how he treats me. Any thoughts? I know the typical argument against that line of thinking, but I need something more to tell him.
I would tell him, you're going to a lawyer and you have got rights to his property and you won't have. And maybe that'll wake him up. You are absolutely his wife. The fact now, I don't know how come you got married. You know, you didn't tell me what happened to the first marriage. But you are 100% wife. And for him to use some cockeyed version of the Bible to justify mistreating you is an outrage. It just makes me very upset to see the way people misuse the Word of God for their own selfish reasons. But you say, how can I wake him up? That's how you do it. Mm-hmm. You say, I've contacted a lawyer, and we're going to have a little time together, and I want half of everything you've got, okay? I am a wife.
That's right.
He says, I don't agree. Well, okay, we'll take it to the judge. Otherwise, let's live in harmony together, okay? What's next?
Linda writes, is it okay to eat foods that are named after the devil? For instance, devil's food cake and deviled eggs. I love deviled eggs. Would I be dishonoring God by eating them?
I don't think so. You know, the rule of this thing is if somebody has got meat that has been offered to an idol,
yeah,
and he doesn't tell you about it, then you eat the meat, give thanks to God, and he'll clean it up. This other thing is just a joke. I mean, black cake is called devil's food, dark chocolate or whatever, devil's food. And the deviled eggs are, yes, they are delicious.
They are. I know, I used to go hiking and camping in a place called Devil's Lake in Wisconsin.
Well, there's a Devil's Knob over in Wintergreen, too.
Most beautiful place I've ever been. And, you know, I didn't like that name, but I still went.
Yeah.
You know, but
I don't think that it has anything. If you don't believe in that stuff and you don't agree with it, and the fact that somebody's given it a name, they have things they call sloppy joes. Well, does that mean Joe slopped in them? Not really. So, you know.